guys, it is Tanya, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to another speed build. Today, we are building an abandoned house, which I'm very, very excited about, because I really love building rundown, overgrown, crazy landscaping houses in the game, and this has been on my to-do list for absolutely ages. Basically, since we got access to the Show Live Edit Objects, gee, I was like, oh my gosh, abandoned houses. Because of overgrown grass, but particularly because there's this one fence that we got that we just got a single diagonal post of it, and it was like, that's perfect to board up windows. So it's October 1st. It's the beginning of spooky season. I'm very excited about it. There's going to be a decent amount of spooky or horror themed builds this month, or just fall ones in general. Not every build though, because I know not everyone's into that, and Halloween is not celebrated everywhere, but I do like to go crazy this time of year because I absolutely love this season. So we're starting off the month with an abandoned house. It's not too spooky, but I feel like it still fits the theme because, you know, kids around the town can have theories about what's going on in there. You might be just afraid to go in there to begin with because it's abandoned. Who could be in there? What animals could be in there? It's a little scary. So that's what we are doing here today. So this house comes in at about 45,000 simoleons. So it's a lot for an abandoned house, to be honest. But I put a lot of details in it and I had a lot of fun. So we're using a ton of the wall pieces, the stains, the cracks, spider webs and stuff that are mostly from vampires, and then Strangerville for like the big green stains that I put everywhere. I think they are so perfect to make this place just look like grungy and old and disgusting, and I hope you guys like it. I also made sure to playtest this build to make sure that everything was functional. So if you did want to play a storyline of, you know, your sim kind of fixing up the place or squatting here and they ran away or whatever, it's all works. It's just really gross looking. And there's stuff everywhere. There's like literal piles of trash in this house and bottles everywhere and spoiled food and pizza and overgrown grass and, you know. But you also have everything you would need. It just looks disgusting, and including a barbecue out back and a couple of planters if you would like to grow some of your own plants. They're kind of buried under the grass, but the grass is from Show Live Edit Objects, so it's totally okay. Because your Sims can walk right through those items. So you can just walk right through everything. I know it looks like you can't navigate at all, but it's like the Sims don't see it. They don't care that it's there and they can keep walking. So we're still on the outside adding lots of stains. It's disgusting. This is like my favorite type of thing to do. And I haven't done one of these in a long time. Actually, it's kind of similar shaped. A couple years ago for April Fool's Day, I built a house that I called my dream house, and it was like a really run-down gross house like this, but I voiced it over like it was my dream house, and I explained like why I loved it and like why I made the decision that I did completely seriously, and that was so fun. I might link that down below as well. I really enjoy doing weird builds for April Fool's Day. Obviously, I've also been talking about doing a lot of stuff for Halloween and October. We'll get into that in a minute, but earlier this year for April Fool's Day, I actually, since I was in the middle of going nuts with tiny houses, I built a tiny house for a toddler, which was essentially half walls and very not functional, and I shrunk everything down, and it was really obnoxious, but I voiced it over super seriously, and the amount of view that fell for it just like made my day, and I really like doing that kind of thing for April Fool's Day, so I'm sure there'll be something next year as well, but since we are in October now, there's going to be all kinds of stuff. And I have a lot of ideas written down, but of course, if you guys have any other ideas, please leave those down below. You could also leave them over on my Discord server because I've been pretty active over there. And actually, I just had to pause a discussion on horror movies to come do this voiceover because I really wanted to get this out and chat with you guys. But also, if you guys want to come over there and chat with us, we've been talking about horror movies and Halloween and October and just everything. It's a really cool place to hang out. So I will have a link down below if you'd like to come and join the Discord server. It's completely free. But anyway, we're boarding up more windows. I did put the ones upstairs as these open ones that came with Jungle Adventure because I just thought it would be kind of cool. Like, those ones were knocked out, the glass is missing, and then they were boarded up, and the other ones are boarded up. I think I cut out some of the windows getting boarded up because it took forever to do all of them because you had to manually raise up all of the pieces of wood, and, you know, I just thought that wouldn't be as interesting to watch. So I did cut out a decent amount of footage in this, but a majority of what you need to see is here. Actually, I think everything, and I think I kept both bathrooms in and the floor plan. There's two bedrooms and two bathrooms, a small kitchen and a small living room. There's no dining space. However, there is like a beat up picnic table on the porch. So there is a place to go and sit and eat if you don't want to sit on the couch. But everything's kind of disheveled, pushed all over the place. There's stains and cracks and garbage everywhere. So it's probably not the nicest place to hang out, but I mean, it is an abandoned house, so that does make sense. I'm also just kind of putting stuff under the grass, like random stuff. We put a rake. That's the word. I was like, a shovely leaf tool. A rake. That's... We put a rake under there, and then I'm also putting graffiti on the door here. I do move it off onto the wall a little bit later. I'm not sure if that's on camera or not, because when I was playtesting it, they couldn't use the front door. They could only use the back door because of that graffiti, so I did move it a little bit later, but there's still graffiti on this house. I thought that was a good addition, and then we're just boarding up more windows. This was a different plank of wood. I did go ahead and swap it out for the same one we were using on the other windows a little bit later. And then getting this little fence post that I was talking about. I love this. It just comes on a slight angle, so it's kind of annoying to get to go straight to be a boarded up window, but we figured it out in the end. And then I'm using these ones mostly on the side. I believe we used one of the diagonal bits. I'm not sure. But then the back of the house, we used some of those, and I just think it came out really cool, and I was very excited to board up windows. I know that's kind of a weird thing to say, but it's just something different to do in the game and a lot of detail, and I got to use a green roof, which is something I mentioned in a video very recently. I don't remember which one, but I was like, I never use green roofs. I want to soon. Well, I found one. It's just an abandoned house. I would like to make a nice house sometime soon with a green roof, though. I also use these fence pieces to kind of look like they were used to try to repair the fence at some point, the missing pieces, which I thought was kind of fun. So hopefully you guys like that. And I have piles of wood everywhere, like what was left from boarding up windows or the ones that were pulled off the windows so people could get inside this abandoned house. Really, whatever stories you guys would like to tell, I think are possible here. Or you could always fix up this house. I think that'd be really cool to see as well. If you decide to like fix up this house and make it back to its former glory, please tweet me pictures on Twitter. I would love to see it. I think that'd be kind of cool at some point. That could be a fun challenge. I'm not going to do that as a build challenge right now, but at some point in time, I'd like to do another build challenge or shell challenge or something on the channel. That'll probably be sometime in the next month or so. I think that could be a lot of fun on top of doing squish tours, which I am so excited to see the submissions later this month. I think we're going to tour them close to Halloween, so I don't remember what deadline I gave in that video, but as long as they're like in before like the second half of the month, I'm very excited to see all the spooky, creepy, tiny houses. There's so much you can come up with, and I've actually seen a couple sneak peeks because people talking about them in Discord, or I actually popped into somebody's stream over on Twitch and saw like some of the stuff in the works. So I'm very excited to see what everyone else comes up with and see the finished versions of all the sneak peeks I've gotten as well. It's just so much fun to go through your guys' builds because you guys are so talented. But we are in the kitchen now, and this is gross. It's just... This is a trash can, but the trash isn't in it. It's on the sides of it, which is kind of gross. And there's cracks and stains, just like every other room in this house. And I have all these stains on the floor as well, which are from Strangerville. And I'm using this tiling or this linoleum. I believe it came with City Living, I want to say. City Living gave us some good worn down things. We got the base game counters in a dirtier swatch. We got like some gross floors, some gross wallpapers. And I definitely use those in this build. It definitely helped quite a bit, but have you guys ever built an abandoned house or done something like this? The first thing I thought of is if anyone's ever built anything for Little Simsy's Fixer Upper, you've probably built something like this. She's fixed up a lot of houses like this in the past. But other than that, have any of you guys built an abandoned house? I think it's so cool. It's so fun. Like so much detail goes into like what happens to the house. Things get like shoved around, like rips and tears, and if you haven't built one before, I would highly suggest it because this was so much fun. But I pretty much knew it was going to be fun because I've noticed I really like building rundown things, like when I did the junkyard or just like really cluttered things like that. Pawn shop I did a couple years ago, just stuff like that. I'm just like, so much fun. Like, I don't want to step away at all. I'm not tired of it. I'm just like, yes. I mean, I did have to do this over 2 days because it got really late and I was like, I need to go to bed. But I didn't want to because I was just like, yes. So I basically did most of the outside on one day and then the interior and finishing up the outside on another day. But yeah, this is the downstairs bathroom. I kind of made the toilet and the sink kind of pulled out from the wall a little bit. I just thought that made it look a little bit more disheveled. I did that a lot, and there's some clothes on the floor because I did imagine that somebody is like squatting here, you know, hiding from someone, or maybe they ran away from home and they're just hiding out here. There's so many stories you can tell about that, so I wanted to make sure it was functional, like I had mentioned, but we're just adding a couple of decorations in the front hallway. I didn't want it to look super put together because, I mean, it is an abandoned house, so we just kind of have a dresser thing in the corner, and there's a bunny statue on it, and then a bunch of cobwebs, because, or maybe there's spider webs, cobwebs, they're probably both. This place is old and filthy, so I don't know how long I imagine this house was abandoned, because it's, the style of it is not overly old, but some of the furniture is, but it's also just like beat up furniture. I wasn't trying to make it look like an old Victorian house or something out of a certain time frame. I was just like beat up old furniture that's been sitting here for a while. It's dirty. That's just the vibe I was going for. So I don't think it's from a specific time period. It could be from any time, I think. But I don't know. I keep saying but and then not having anything to say after it. But there we go. I did it again. This is the living room coming together. Just a big crack on the wall. That crack always makes me think of Doctor Who. It never won't. And some more rips and tears. I think it's so cool that the Vampire Pack gave us so many of those things. I use them a lot in this build, but I've used them a lot in general, just like some storytelling of somebody punched the wall and there's a hole in the wall, or there's just like one crack and they're covering it by a painting. I think it's super cool that we got stuff like that. And the stains from Strangerville, like more floor stuff, I think is so cool. Also with Get Famous, I didn't use it in this build, but there is a rug that's just a giant crack in the floor. And I thought that one was really cool as well. And I'm definitely open to getting more of this kind of stuff. But honestly, if I can get any kind of build mode stuff or buy mode stuff, both stuff, I want tiny home related stuff. And I've talked about this so many times before, and I still don't think we're ever going to get it. But it would be so useful, whether you're really into tiny homes or not, just having smaller sinks and stuff, or sink and toilet combos and things like that in a bathroom would be so cool. I've talked about this a thousand times before, but I got reminded of it because one of you guys commented on a video in the last day or two, basically saying exactly what I said right now. And I was like, yes, I mean, I've been saying this for ages, but like, I want it so bad. Maybe if more of us are like, we need this, it'll happen. But I don't know. It'd be cool. But I'm saying but again, we have this rug in the upstairs hallway. I just kind of have stuff shoved around, not quite flush with the wall. And then we have two bedrooms. One is a single bed, one is a double bed. They're both kind of squished in and have garbage everywhere. There's not a whole lot to say about them because they're just dirty bedrooms that are gross and disgusting, using all of the adjectives to describe. But I hope you guys like this. I've said that before, but it should be available on the Sims 4 gallery if you search Griffey or the hashtag Miss Griffey. That information will also be down below, as well as a link to the gallery website if you'd like to download it that way as well. I think I mentioned this is 45,000 simoleons, so it's a little pricey, but if you're doing it for storytelling anyway, or if you just want to fix up this house, I guess the price doesn't really matter. I wonder if you could fix up this house not with any additional budget, just like deleting all the gross stuff and then, you know, fully furnishing it nicely without any extra money, just using what it's worth. That could be a challenge. That's interesting. Maybe I will try that at some point. But let me know what you guys are thinking as far as some other spooky builds are going, or what other spooky or Halloween or fall themed builds you guys would like to see. My words are just not working today. That happens sometimes. But we're just adding some more bottles and stuff in the kitchen. I just wanted to make it nice and cluttered. And I love the spider webs everywhere and the little fountain in the sink to make it look like it's broken. I did test that sink. You can still use it, which I didn't think you were going to be able to. I did put one in the downstairs toilet as well, but that made it not functional, so I deleted it. And we're putting some, well, I thought about putting some paintings more on the walls here. I think we just keep that one from Strangerville and don't put anything else other than some cracks and tears. And yeah, that's pretty much this bedroom. That's pretty much this whole build. There's still like 2 minutes though. So what else do I do? There's an upstairs bathroom. I forgot about that. We have a tub in that one, like a clawfoot tub. I thought that was kind of cool. And there was space for that. And I don't think the showers look as like easy to make look run down. Although the tub's not really run down. I just made the walls and stuff in there run down. I'm also adding a plank of wood that we had outside on the inside. I have no idea why it's there, but I kind of liked that. I was really enjoying just putting stuff in random places for no reason. There's some dirty dishes and a bunny statue on this bedside table. Why? I have no idea. There's a fire extinguisher. I think that's a good thing to have. I also put this pile of wood under the bed, but I had to delete it in the end because it made the bed not functional. But everything else in there stays the same, and then we're adding just some more junk out in the backyard. I really enjoyed doing that. It's just somehow very realistic to me, even though I don't think I've seen a yard or like a house that's super abandoned like this that has so much stuff in the yard. I've definitely seen abandoned houses where like the windows are boarded up or broken in and there's crazy amounts of grass, but there's usually not that much stuff outside, but it's The Sims and I can just play around and have fun with it. So that's exactly what I did. But yeah, this is the final bathroom in the house. We're gonna use a clawfoot tub and a bunch of cracks and stuff on the walls, and of course making sure nothing is like flat against the wall because that makes it look too new and not beat up for some reason. We're coming to the end of the video though, so I hope you guys did enjoy this. If you did, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. You can also subscribe to the channel if you have not already, and if you click that bell, it'll turn on notifications so you'll be notified of every single time I upload a new video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye everybody.